concepts in finance and probably in business is the time value of money. A dollar today is worth more than a dollar tomorrow, because if you have that dollar today, you can invest it and earn interest. And what happens in textbooks and in the real world is we're given three variables and have to find the fourth, or sometimes we're given the four variables and have to find the fifth. So let's do a little problem that walks us through that process. This problem is from a textbook, and it always gives students problems. Approximately how many years would it take for an investment to grow fourfold if it were invested at 16% compounded semi-annually? And unfortunately, the textbook talks about the rule of 72 in the chapter that precedes this homework, and everyone thinks that somehow the rule of 72 plays into this. The rule of 72 is this kind of parlor trick that allows you to estimate how long it'll take you to double your money. But this question doesn't ask about doubling your money, it asks about quadrupling your money. And this is going to be one of those instances when we're given three of the variables and we have to find the fourth. Since there's no payments in this problem that are changing, we can use our friend the third row. All right, so what do we know? We know the interest rate is, the annual rate is 16%, compounded semi-annually. That means that the periodic rate is 8%. 16% per year is 8% per semi-annual period. We also know that we're going to quadruple our money. So here I assume we spent $100 and got back $400. This could be $1 and $4, or $4 and $16, whatever number we plug in here as dollars out, we're going to get four times that as dollars in. And all that's left now is to solve. We have for the N. We have the I, we have the PV, and we have the future value. I'm going to hit second FV, that clears out the third row. N is what we're going to solve for. What's the interest per period? It's 8. 8i. If it's 16 per year and it compounds semi-annually, that means it's 8% per six-month period. What's the PV? In this case, I decided it was $100. Change that to dollars out. PV. Payment, there is none in this problem. But the future value is the 400 positive. 400 future value. Now we're going to solve for the N, so we hit compute N, and it tells us it's approximately 18 six-month periods. 18 six-month periods is approximately 9 years. So that's the answer to the problem. Just a little heads up, notice it isn't 18 even, it's 18.01. If you use a different calculator, you'll get a slightly different answer. Let's use the HP12C. We'll plug in 8 as the I, we'll plug in 100 change sign as the PV, we'll plug in 400 as the future value, and now we'll solve for N, and we'll get 19 instead of 18. And the reason is it takes a little bit more than 18 six-month periods to get to that $400, and HP rounds up from 18 to 19. So don't be confused if you get a slightly different answer if you're using the HP calculator instead of the Texas Instruments calculator. All right, hope that helps.